Hey, do you do any data validation on your Power BI reports?
Oh yeah, we do data validation.
What kind of validations do you do?
I like to do counts and amounts, number of records, some value or more values, something like that. Do you have reporting on that? How do you track that? Once we get that down, they'll break out by a bunch of different dimensions, at least one value on each of the dimensions. You do anything to help when it comes to troubleshooting and resolving issues, like helping people when you find an issue, like know what to do to fix it? We like to provide some hints, tips, some instructions or guidelines or links to documentation on like how you resolve any load issues. Do you want to see them?
Yeah.
All right. Let me show you. Come on.
Okay, so you've built out an incredible Power BI reports and you've got a great model, but one of the foundational things people are constantly going to be asking is this data right? You need to have some way to monitor and ensure that the information that's in your model is matching the sources as you'd expect them to be. All right, so that's why I like to look at building this type of system and this type of analytics reporting on top of my analytics. All right, I call this data validation process counts and amounts. All right, I'm going to show you how you can do that with four really simple steps. All right, let's head over to it. Okay, the first thing is understanding what does counts and amounts mean. We want to understand the number of either records or the number of items or transactions that occur inside of a system, as well as some dollar value amount that exists inside of our fact table to help us make sure that the information that we're seeing is right, it's accurate, and it's true to the source. And more importantly, that it breaks out and distributes by the different dimensions inside of our model as it should and as we'd expect to from the various source systems. So how we're going to do that is we're going to build out a very small aggregated source query that's going to pull all this information together and either bring in the keys, just the keys necessary to join to my various dimensions, or bring in the business keys in order to do that. Once we have the validation query, I'm going to create a Power BI report. I'm going to connect to my enterprise data set that I'm trying to validate against, and I'm going to turn that into a composite model by adding in that validation query and then joining it to the various dimensions as we've I've already kind of planned that out. Once I've got those together, I'm going to create some measures that kind of add, subtract, make sure that these values that we're getting line up and it's good to go. And then once that's all together, then I'm going to go in and create a report that provides me line of sight into what's going inside of my model, provide some guidance and troubleshooting tips for what do you do when this issue happens? How do you fix it? Where do you go to fix this type of thing? Where's some documentation on it? Right. So I'm going to include that all inside of my report so it becomes really easy for me to build and manage it. All right. Now let's go ahead and take a look at this stuff. Okay. So once I've got my model up, and this is the fact table I want to validate my reseller sales. Now, I'm going to be creating a very small, highly aggregated query to connect to the various dimensions inside of my model. Now, I have to be very mindful that I don't go down to the lowest granularity. Otherwise, I'm just going to be building out this huge, huge, huge fact table, right? So I just want to go down to the grain that's necessary for my validations, and that will run very, very quickly. Okay. So in this case, I've gone through and I've identified these are dimensions that I have that have very low cardinality that I can validate these things out and get a really good feel for the quality of the data that exists inside of my system. Okay. Now you can do some more detailed ones, but just try to make sure as you go and build out and develop your query that it's going to be sufficient for, or it's going to run quickly and it's very lightweight and it adds in a big key. You do not want to exceed 100,000 records on your cardinality because in a composite model, there is a threshold of the number of joins that can be submitted back and forth, and it's just over 100,000 records. So you want to make sure you're well under that limit when it comes to doing your data validation, or you're going to run into problems in your validation. And that's going to really be because you have a flawed methodology and not that you have a bad data set. Okay. So once I've defined what it is I'm going to be building out, then I'm going to go over to my source system to try and either pull in hopefully the keys that I'm using, if not the business keys, so that when I add in my validation table into my model, I can make sure that all of these joins are set up to that validation table, right? So that's how we're going to do it. So next step is we're going to go over to Management Studio, and this is where we're going to go build the query. I'm going to go and I'm going to connect to the SQL Server, and I've kind of already prepped up my query, okay? So my source of this is my SQL data DW. You can do validation against this. This would allow you to test to make sure that your refreshes are running as soon as your SQL DW is finished loading. But ideally, you'd want to go further back upstream to do this test. But this can be done here as well to make sure that you're keeping all your data in sync. Okay. So I've written my query, grouping my business keys at the top. I have my summation in the center. And then I've got my group bys on the bottom, okay? This is going to be a very lightweight query. All right, this is a very lightweight query. As you can see, returned 60,000 records in less than a second, right? So insanely fast, right? So this is good. And I can know that the granular level that I'm going to is 60,000 different slices and dices that I'm going to get out of this. So this is a pretty good way to validate my information, okay? Now, what I'm going to do is I am going to take this query, and I'm going to bring this over, and I'm going to put this into this model right here. We're going to put it here. And the thing I'm going to do is I'm going to join that up to all the different tables to make sure that it works. And then it's going to be good to go. Okay. Now, through the magic of edits, there you go. Now I've already brought this in. And I've got my validation queries. These are all joined over to my tables. I've got my one-to-many joins already in place. So I am set. I'm good to go for this validation, okay? Now, next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and I'm going to define my summation values. So this is just the reseller order, quantities to summation, right? So I'm going to set those guys up. And then I'm going to add in the differences, okay? And the differences are going to take the original amount, reseller order sales quantity. I'm going to subtract the new validation query that I'm going to have. And this is important, I'm going to round this to zero decimal place, okay? Now, you say, hey, Chris, why are you rounding this to zero decimal place? I'm glad you asked. It's because of this guy right here, this little, like, not really a decimal point, but it's kind of a decimal point that gets caught in there for, I don't know, translating currencies and stuff like that, right? But that number added up, you can add on a few cents. If you have a really large database and with millions and millions of, well, billions of records, maybe, maybe even add a few dollars onto it, okay? Generally speaking, though, if you round it up to a dollar and then, round it up to the dollar, give yourself a plus minus $1. And you're going to be good to go when it comes to doing your validations across things, okay? But that's the key. Once I've got this in place, now it's time to move on to the report, okay? Now, I've put this example together where I've already start at the top line, and I make sure that my count is not is spot on, as well as my amount. Hey, this is good to go, right? So it looks like everything's fine, but we need to go into more detail because just because the totals amounts match doesn't mean things are lining up right with my keys, right? You think, how the heck can that go wrong? Well, it can go wrong, right? There's all sorts of things that happen inside of our processing, all right? So if I go over and look at, like, for example, this dim date validation, okay? Now, you can see here, I've got issues. I've got discrepancies in my loads, right? Where we have things and numbers that are off. Totals are right, but the amounts in any given period are off, right? So with this, I include what the fix should be and then how to go in and resolve it. So in most cases, the fix that we're going to do is to, you know, refresh all partitions in the fact table and validate again, right? That's first step one, right? See if that fixes it. If not, this is something where you might need to review your partition strategy. So for example, the way I kind of had to like almost break my model to get it to be off. So what I did is I broke my partition strategy, so it didn't work and it moved things into the wrong place, right? So I could give you an example of this, but having an incorrect partition strategy is actually something that happens not fairly often, but it does happen. And when those things happen, when you have these transactions and changes that occur, where you can see duplication, you can see missing records, all that stuff, this allows you to go in and find those things and sort that out, okay? But I also go through on each of the dimensions, making sure that each of these are set up in place and that things are right. And if not, always providing what the initial thing is, which is almost always a refresh or recalc. And if not, where do you go? Like, hey, do a review of the surrogate key generation and then look at a load strategy from HR, right? For the employee dimension validation, right? Now, as we go through other things, you know, there might be other challenges that you need to sort out, right? So in this case, our promotions are managed by a third-party vendor, right? So, okay, hey, you know, you need to go to the third-party system. Here's a link right here for where people can go to get additional help, all right? Now, once I've got this out, I publish this out into my service, making sure that this is accessible to everyone and that we've got a consistent place that people can go to and have a conversation around this stuff. I also do like to post it inside of Teams so that there's a real good place to have that conversation, to go back and forth with data engineering, to call out and say, hang on, you know, hey, Power BI Luchador, you know, we've got some issue inside of our date dimensions. Things aren't going right. Can you do a refresh? And maybe we need to look at the partitions, right? It's something that's very helpful to have out there, all right? Well, thank you guys so much for tuning in today. I hope you found this useful. Remember, making sure that your data is valid and is right is one of the key things that we need to be focusing on as analysts and people who work inside of this space. Low quality or data that people can't trust is data that people don't use. Or worse, it's data that people use and then they do the wrong things because the data is wrong, right? And they don't know it, right? So having some sort of ongoing, persistent checking and managing of your data to ensure that you don't have any issues is really, really important. All right. I hope you found this useful. I'm going to do a part two where I show you how you can use this to build out a metrics app to, you know, do long range tracking, but more on that in that video. So thank you guys very much. You guys have a great day. Peace.